Boeing Starliner spacecraft has successfully landed in the New Mexico desert.
Without the two astronauts that carried to the International Space Station earlier this year.
Well, they're now waiting on SpaceX for their ride home.
Boeing Starliner set to return to Earth tomorrow without its crew.
Boeing Starliner spacecraft returned to Earth without its crew after a technical issue cut its mission short. The capsule landed safely in the New Mexico desert, but the astronauts stayed aboard the International Space Station. NASA chose to leave Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams in orbit, considering it the safest option. What really caused the Starliner's unexpected return? Let's uncover the full story behind this event that nobody wants to talk about. Starliner's big move stuns NASA. NASA's recent mission update was quite the news. They shared that the Starliner spacecraft had a really good day during its whole space trip, especially when it was time to leave the space station. The spacecraft used NASA's special docking system, which worked perfectly for the second time on this mission, helping the Starliner smoothly detach from the space station. This same system is going to be used for the Orion spacecraft in future missions, so this was a big step forward. But what unexpected event occurred right after Starliner's smooth departure that could change the course of future missions? Stay with us as we reveal the surprising twist that NASA didn't see coming. The Starliner didn't just unhook and drift away. It performed a carefully planned move called a breakout sequence. This was the first time NASA used this method to move the spacecraft away from the station. It backed away about 16 feet, then did a series of 12 engine burns using the jets on its service module. This helped the spacecraft get about 13 miles away from the station each time it orbited the Earth. The thrusters, those little engines that help steer the spacecraft, worked really well, which was great news. Rebecca Morrell, who writes about science stuff, summed up how the mission went. She said it was a safe and successful landing, even though there were some issues with the thrusters as the spacecraft was coming back down to Earth. There had been some problems with these thrusters when the spacecraft was going up into space, which is why they decided not to have any astronauts on board this time. They wanted to make sure everything was super safe before putting people on board. Rebecca mentioned that even though the landing went well, it was kind of sad because the spacecraft was supposed to bring two astronauts, Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams, back home. Instead, it came back empty after many years of planning and testing. This was a big moment because it wrapped up a test flight that didn't include any astronauts. Butch and Sonny, the astronauts who were supposed to come home, will now have to stay on the International Space Station a lot longer than they thought, 8 months instead of just 8 days. NASA is making sure they have everything they need by sending up multiple cargo missions with essential items like clothes and other important stuff to make their extended stay as comfortable as possible. Staying healthy in space is crucial, especially without gravity. Both astronauts keep up with their exercise routines to make sure their muscles and bones stay strong. They're also keeping busy by working on science experiments. The space station is like a big science lab that orbits the Earth, and they're helping to find out all kinds of interesting things while they're up there. There are quite a few astronauts on the space station right now, and they switch out who's up there every so often. There's an interesting change coming up with the next SpaceX Crew Dragon mission in September. Originally, they were going to send four astronauts, but now they're only sending two, one from NASA and one from Russia. This change is to make sure there are enough seats for Butch and Sonny when it's time for them to finally come home in February. Space travel involves a lot of planning, especially when it comes to making sure there are enough spacecraft at the station, just in case they need to quickly bring everyone back to Earth in an emergency. Dottie Metcalf-Lindenberger, who used to be an astronaut, shared some insights about how space missions work. She said that astronauts don't have to bring everything with them because a lot of their equipment and supplies are already up there or sent up during missions. The next SpaceX mission will bring even more supplies, but astronauts don't need as much as you might think. For example, they don't need a lot of clothes because they can wear the same outfit for longer in space, and there's always plenty of food. Butch and Sonny will keep doing important science work and experiments while they wait for their trip back home. Dottie also talked about her own experience in space. She was a shuttle astronaut and was only supposed to be in space for 11 days, but ended up staying for 15 due to some issues with the shuttle. But even in that short time, she felt like they had more than enough stuff, especially clothes. It turns out you don't need as much in space as you might think on Earth. While space missions are incredibly complex and involve a lot of high-tech equipment and careful planning, the day-to-day life of astronauts is quite different from what we might imagine. They have to deal with unique challenges like living in zero gravity and making sure they stay healthy. But they also get to participate in cutting-edge science experiments and contribute to our understanding of the universe. It's a tough job, but also incredibly exciting and important. And with each mission, we learn more about how to safely explore space, which paves the way for future missions, and maybe one day, regular trips to other planets for more of us. NASA's story is full of victories and challenges, but one event made a big difference in how space exploration moved forward. NASA's Race to the Moon begins. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, also known as NASA, was set up in 1958 by the US government. This was due to the Soviet Union launching Sputnik in 1957, which sparked what's known as the space race. NASA started off from an earlier group focused on aeronautics research. Its goal widened quickly from just studying flight to also tackling space exploration. One of the big early wins for NASA was launching the Explorer 1 satellite in January of 1958, kicking off America's entry into space. Not long after, President John F. Kennedy set a bold goal to land a man on the moon. This dream was achieved with the Apollo program, which is very famous at NASA. Neil Armstrong was the first man to walk on the moon on July 20, 1969, a huge win after many manned missions that built up to Apollo 11. This mission showed American space leadership during the Cold War. NASA didn't just stop with the moon. They've sent unmanned missions all over our solar system. Early ones, like the Mariner missions, checked out Mars and Venus. The Pioneer and Voyager missions went even further, sending back the first images and data from the outer planets. The Voyager probes, launched in the late 1970s, are still sending back info from beyond our solar system. NASA's also big on tech development, especially with satellites and space telescopes. The Hubble Space Telescope, launched in 1990, changed how we see the universe, giving us close-up views of faraway galaxies and stars. Hubble's discoveries are still important today. Another major role for NASA has been working on the International Space Station, ISS. Built with many countries, the ISS has had astronauts living in it continuously since 2000. It's a lab for science in space, helping learn about everything from biology to physics. This shows NASA's shift from competing in space during the Cold War to working together with other countries. NASA has had its tough times too. Disasters like the Challenger in 1986 and Columbia in 2003 were tragic, with all crew lost. These led to big changes in how NASA handles safety. After the Columbia accident, NASA ended the space shuttle program and started looking toward future space travel methods. Today, NASA has new aims like getting back to the moon with the Artemis program and going to Mars. The Artemis missions plan to have astronauts, including the first woman, back on the moon by the mid-2020s. They're not just about visiting, they're testing tech for Mars trips. NASA's Mars rovers, like Curiosity and Perseverance, have been finding out heaps about Mars, checking if it ever could have supported life. NASA hasn't forgotten its roots in aeronautics. It keeps working on making air travel better and safer. The tech from NASA has helped lots of other industries too, from how we communicate to health tech. Looking ahead, NASA is planning to go further into space than ever. The James Webb Space Telescope is going to take over from Hubble, giving us an even deeper look into space. They're also planning missions to asteroids to learn more about how our solar system formed. A big goal is to send humans to Mars, aiming for even more groundbreaking discoveries in space exploration. Throughout its history, NASA has been about mixing scientific curiosity with the need to push technological limits and explore what's out there. They've landed people on the moon, sent probes to distant planets, and always aimed to go further. Today, NASA stands as a leader in exploring space, continuing to bring the wonders of the universe closer to us and pushing the edges of what's possible in space and technology. Looking back at NASA's achievements, it's clear that tough moments helped teach important lessons, and one tragedy left a lasting impact on space exploration. Apollo 1's fire shakes NASA. Space exploration has had its fair share of heartbreaks and disasters, reminding us all of how risky the travel to and from outer space can be. These tragedies are crucial reminders of what astronauts and space organizations face as they push the boundaries of human knowledge and capabilities. One of the earliest and most severe of these tragedies occurred on January 27, 1967. NASA faced a devastating incident with the Apollo 1 spacecraft during a routine check before its scheduled launch. A fire unexpectedly erupted inside the command module, where three astronauts were preparing for their upcoming mission. The flames were fueled by highly flammable materials in an oxygen-rich environment, making the fire spread quickly and fiercely. Tragically, the astronauts could not escape due to a hatch that was difficult to open fast enough. This horrific event brought the Apollo program to a temporary standstill and forced a comprehensive reassessment of spacecraft safety protocols. A few months later, on April 24, 1967, a similar catastrophe occurred with the Soviet Union's Soyuz 1. Vladimir Komarov, the only astronaut aboard, faced severe technical issues soon after launch, one being a solar panel that failed to deploy. These complications escalated during his return trip when the parachute system malfunctioned, resulting in a deadly crash. Komarov's death marked the first time an astronaut died because of a spaceflight accident, underlining the serious risks of conducting space missions with unresolved technical problems. Another tragic event in the Soviet space program took place in 1971 with the Soyuz 11 mission. After spending 23 days aboard the first space station, Salyut 1, the returning cosmonauts faced a life-threatening situation. A valve malfunction during their descent caused the cabin to lose pressure rapidly. This sudden depressurization led to the cosmonauts dying from asphyxiation. Following this tragedy, it became mandatory for astronauts to wear pressure suits during re-entry, a change aimed at preventing similar deadly incidents in the future. Perhaps the most infamous space tragedy occurred with the Space Shuttle Challenger on January 28, 1986. Just 73 seconds after liftoff, the shuttle broke apart, resulting in the deaths of all seven crew members, including Krista McAuliffe, who was part of NASA's Teacher in Space project. Cold temperatures had caused the O-rings and the solid rocket boosters to fail, leading to this catastrophic failure. This disaster profoundly impacted the public and led to major overhauls in NASA's safety practices to ensure such a tragedy would not happen again. Another somber chapter was written on February 1, 2003, with the loss of the Space Shuttle Columbia. After a successful 16-day mission, disaster struck upon re-entry. A piece of foam detached from the shuttle's external fuel tank during launch, damaging the thermal protection on the left wing. As the shuttle re-entered the Earth's atmosphere, this damage allowed superheated gases to enter the wing, causing the entire shuttle to disintegrate and eliminating all seven astronauts aboard. This heart-wrenching incident marked the beginning of the end for NASA's shuttle program, which eventually concluded in 2011. These awful events have really changed how we think about keeping people safe when they go into space. Both NASA in America and the Russian Space Group have put a lot of work into making better spacecraft, improving how they launch, and creating safer emergency plans. Even though heading into space is still pretty risky, every bad thing that happens teaches us something new that helps make future space trips safer. There have been other accidents related to spacecraft that maybe you haven't heard much about, but they've also made a big difference. Take the Apollo 13 mission back in 1970, for example. It could have ended really badly after an oxygen tank blew up on the way to the moon, which caused a big problem with the power and the systems that keep the astronauts alive. But the crew and the people back on Earth figured out a way to fix things quickly and smartly, and everyone got back home safely. It was one of those moments in space history that really kept everyone on the edge of their seats. Even after heartbreaking losses, space exploration continued with more focus, and the lessons learned from the past now guide today's missions. Shuttle close calls that nearly ended badly. During the time when we were sending up space shuttles, there were quite a few close calls, not just the big disasters you might know about. Like this one time in 1983, the Space Shuttle Challenger had a fuel leak that could have ended really badly if it hadn't been caught and fixed just in time. Then in 1995, the Space Shuttle Atlantis had a scare with a fuel pump while it was going up. But luckily, they found the problem early enough that they could fix it and get the shuttle back to Earth without anyone getting hurt. From the very start of the space race, the US and the Soviet Union were always trying to push what we knew about technology and what people could handle. Even though they achieved a lot, the accidents and problems along the way reminded us just how tricky and unexpected space can be. The near miss with Apollo 13, the sad ending of Soyuz 11, and the big failures of the Challenger and Columbia shuttles show just how careful you have to be when you send people into space. Every time there's a successful mission, there are tons of challenges that the astronauts and the engineers have to overcome. This could be problems with coming back into Earth's atmosphere, like what happened with Soyuz 1, or weird things happening during launch, like the piece of foam that hit the Columbia shuttle. Space agencies have to be ready for all kinds of issues. These past problems highlight why it's so important to always be on your toes, to test everything thoroughly, and to be willing to stop everything if it means keeping people safe. The lessons we've learned from these tough times have been used to make newer spacecraft safer. In today's missions, whether they're to the International Space Station or planning to go back to the moon, really benefit from the hard lessons learned by those who came before them. Even with all the new gadgets and safety improvements, going into space is still one of the hardest things people try to do. It needs the latest tech, but also the bravery of astronauts who are willing to step into the unknown. As more companies start to get involved in space travel, and as new space programs pop up, the impact of past disasters will continue to shape how we explore space. The safety steps that were created because of earlier accidents are now a basic part of planning for current missions. The space industry has gotten bigger, but the dangers are still there. And remembering these past tragedies keeps reminding us of what can happen if we're not careful. Let's talk about what actually goes into making these missions safer. It all starts with learning from what went wrong before. Whether it's a malfunction during launch or something breaking on the spacecraft while it's way up there, every incident gives us clues on how to do better next time. Engineers and scientists look at every little detail to figure out what happened and make sure it doesn't happen again. This could mean changing the design of a part, using different materials, or updating the software that controls the spacecraft. Training for astronauts has also gotten a lot better because of these past problems. They spend a lot of time practicing what to do in all kinds of emergencies, from fires to sudden losses of power. This training happens in simulators that mimic what it's like in space, so when astronauts are up there for real, they feel like they've been through it all before. And it's not just about making the spacecraft and the astronauts ready. The whole process of planning and running a mission has improved. There's a lot more checking and double checking before a spacecraft ever leaves the ground. Teams on the ground are always watching and ready to step in if something starts going wrong. They have plans for all sorts of emergencies, and they practice these plans over and over. Is Boeing Starliner simply facing technical problems, or is there something bigger that NASA isn't telling us? Let us know your thoughts, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more.